Hey everybody, Ryan Marrinan here for 3M. We're gonna show you today some tips and tricks on how to replicate a door skin seam sealer bead, particularly here on this Ford F-150. We're gonna head inside and get started. All right guys, so we're gonna show you how we're gonna replicate that look on that Ford door skin inner panel. You know, if we're replacing a door, we're doing a door skin, something that's a little bit unique to Ford is they have kind of a squared off edge, but it still looks like a float out seam sealer. So we're gonna show you how we're gonna do that here today. On our panel, we've already got it prepped. We've epoxy primed it because we had some exposed bare metal. We've got it scuffed, and we've taped it off to the exact width of the bead that we're trying to replicate. First thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna grab our 8323 product over here. It's our factory match seam sealer. And like any time you grab one of our cartridges, we're gonna equalize it upright into a paper towel, making sure that we got equal parts A and B coming out of the cartridge. Once we apply the static mixing nozzle to the cartridge, we're gonna dispense a little bit onto preferably a mixing board, or you can put it back into that same paper towel. What we're looking at doing here is we wanna just create a couple inches of material, making sure that we've got it thoroughly mixed as it comes through the tip. Now this particular product could also be used in a hand caulking applicator. I'm using a pneumatic here today. It's got a lower viscosity, so just a little tip. Turn the air pressure down just a little bit before you dispense it onto the vehicle or onto the part you're replacing so that we're not making a mess. And what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna get it caulked out. As you can see, it came out pretty quick. So we had to move a little quick, but I made sure that I maintained that angle so that I was pushing the seam sealer into that hem flange. As this starts to settle down, it's gonna create a nice tight seal along that, which is important. What we're gonna do is we're gonna come in with a spreader. I've cut some down to like a third of the size here. And we're just gonna knock that material down, making sure that it makes it all the way from tape to tape. Because again, the tape is actually the desired width that we want that seam sealer bead to be. So we're not concerned about what's come over on top. Once I have this caulked out, we're gonna go ahead and pull our tape. Now the best practice for applying this to a new panel, replacement, paddle, whatever it might be that you're working on, is I always like to start in one location and work my way around to an ending position. And that's the same case when I lay out my tape, when I caulk out my material, and then when I hit it with the spreader just to knock it down. And when I come back to remove my tape, I'm gonna start from that same position again. This gives the material roughly the equal amount of time to rest on the panel. And so when we pull our tape, we're gonna get about the same amount of look as we travel around that panel. As we pull our tape off, you'll notice that I'm pulling backwards against itself, almost cutting that edge clean. It's important here that we pull it either straight back or maybe even inward just a little bit. We don't want to pull it outward and create sort of what we call a wave, because then we got to be concerned about getting paint inside there to make sure we got good corrosion protection. So best practice is if you actually just pull it inward just a little bit, as you're pulling back, you'll get a nice clean edge. Now with this factory match seam sealer, what's gonna happen here is this will have just a slight amount of sag to it. It is a two-part urethane. So we're gonna get that clean squared edge. It will round just a little bit so you get a nice look to it, just like they have on the trucks. And then we're gonna take a spreader again and we're gonna pinch off the corners. Now in the case of some vehicles, they start up a little bit higher with how they pinch off that bead. Now it's important that we pinch this off, and while the material's still in a working condition, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna kinda clean that up. If you need to, you can also use our G-Pack or our specialty adhesive cleaner as a tooling aid while we're working on these panels. After our initial tooling, you can use these products to create sort of that final look if you haven't achieved it just by some rough tooling. So we're gonna clean up a little bit of mess here and a little bit on this edge that I don't like, because again, I want it to look just like it did from the factory, like we didn't replace the panel. So now I've created that clean look. If I need to, I could come in here with my finger a little bit. I could smooth that out. Now it's important that we follow what the OEM recommendation is here. And in this case, they want us to pinch off these corners. And it's important for a few reasons. But particularly, we don't want water building up along this lower edge. If water builds up here, it needs a place to drain off, which is why they actually pinch off the corners on the panels. They also do this for gasket clearances and some other reasons. But we want to make sure that the water isn't sitting on that surface, eating away at it, and causing problems down the road. All right, guys, that's it for this bead here today. For more information on our seam sealers, visit 3M Collision Repair Academy. The link is in the description below. Also, check out some of the other videos on our page. If you hit subscribe and the bell below, you'll get the notification when we release new videos so that you're staying up to date on the best practices in the industry. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Make a comment in the section below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.